In this video, we are going to learn about stochastic process. So the question like what is stochastic process, we are going to discuss, and we are also going to understand that if I have an observed series, let's say GDP, you know, is it really stochastic or not? That's the confusion that arises. So let me first explain you what is stochastic process. A collection of random variable ordered in time is nothing but stochastic process. So let's understand it better. Let's say we throw 6 dice together. So each dice can have value of either 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6. So essentially in that case, the sum of all the 6 faces will be, the minimum value will be 6, because you know when every dice is showing 1, and the maximum value can be 36 when every dice is showing 6. So when you are throwing 6 dice together, the sum will be between 6 to 36. Now suppose you are doing it every hour, you know, every day. For example, let's say you threw dice some 6th and you know on 7th and 8th and 9th, and then you know take the sum, then what you are observing, you know, if you take a look, these are random variable. Why? Because the sum could have been anything between 6 to 36, and now it is ordered in time, right? You are putting 6, then 7, then 8, then 9. So these are random variables. These are random variables because the sum could have been between 6 to 36, anything, and these are ordered in time. So this series is nothing but a stochastic process. Now the second question comes, you know, that someone, suppose, you know, like say, how come a GDP is a stochastic process? You know, GDP value is given, then how come, what is the relationship with the stochastic process? Or let's look at the example that we saw just now, you know, the sum of dice value, how it is a stochastic process? You know, if someone says that this graph, you know, how come it is stochastic? Once you have observed the data, you know it is 21, you know it is 15, you know it is 13, then how come it is stochastic in nature? To explain you better, let me take you to the Excel sheet using which I have generated this. See here, you know, I had put a formula. You can take a look at the formula. 7 into rand. Rand generates anything between 0 to 1. And when you are multiplying by 7, the value can be anything, you know, 0 to 7 and, you know, 6.99, because rand doesn't take the value of 1. And when you are taking floor, it will, value will be between 1 to, between 0 to 7, you know, 0 to 6. Ideally, I should put something so that, you know, it doesn't go beyond 1 ever. So let me do it this way, you know, I'll put 1 plus and 6 star so that, you know, like the value doesn't go anytime above that. You know, I dragged it for all the days, you know, and below is nothing but the sum. These are the sum of the values that you are getting. Now, the values will be always between 1 to 6. Because I have taken 6 into rand, so it will, the maximum value will be 5 and 1 plus, so it will be 1 to 6 the value. Now if you take a look at this series, what you need to understand that this series can take any value. This, you know, this observed value could have been anything. Why? Just, you know, when you repeat any process in Excel, it just regenerates the random number. So essentially if I go here and double click, you know, it will generate the whole set of random number again. So if you take, you know, it has generated the random number, it has plotted it. So what I'm trying to say, that 22, 21, 19, what you are observing, you know, this could have been anything, you know, between 6 to 36. The whatever it is, you know, an observed value is very much, you know, like what is, it's a particular outcome of a stochastic process. So even if you're seeing a particular outcome of a stochastic process, it is still a stochastic process. You know, the way like you get a sample, and in case of ML estimate, you try to understand from which kind of population you could have got this kind of sample. Similarly, in real life, you will get one value of a series, you know, maybe a GDP value or growth rate or whatever. And then you try to understand what kind of population this series would have generated, what kind of population would have generated this kind of series. So what kind of stochastic process would have generated this kind of series? What you are seeing is an actual value of the stochastic process, observed value. It's just a particular outcome of a stochastic process. So in a way, like from the population, the way you take mean, take a sample and you get a particular value. Similarly, the observed values are nothing but a particular observed value of a stochastic process, but the series is still stochastic. So just to take you back, this series is stochastic. When you are getting a GDP, that's still a stochastic process. What is sample to population? Similarly, observed value is to the stochastic process. Observed value, like sample, is a particular outcome taken from the population. Similarly, the observed value is a particular outcome of the stochastic equation. The next, you can view more videos on this particular channel on these topics. Thank you.